Okay, in this section, I want to talk all about the stroke. That's the black outline that you can apply to any of your designs. So how do we start off? I'm going to start from fresh. So we have a blue filled star with no stroke. So what I'm going to do now, because remember, we can play around with the UI and drag it out. So I'm just going to drag the color over there, and I'm going to drag the stroke over here so that we can see exactly the changes I'm making right next to the shape. So on the color tab, you see here, the fill, I don't want to fill, so I'm going to fit it to none. Then I'll click on the stroke here, and I'll just ensure it's black by just going up like that. Okay, great, the color is fine. Now let's move over to the stroke tab. So with the stroke tab, I want to increase the width like we did before. So I'll just increase the width like that. Okay, great. So what are these other options here underneath? Well, cap, if I click on it now, you won't really see a difference. And that's because this more applies to open curves, as this shape is a closed curve. So let's go ahead and just grab the pen tool. I'll just click on that. Now we'll just click once here and click once here, and then we have an open curve, and we're going to play around with the cap on this. So take note, the ends are rounded from here, as you can see, and the next one will be butt cap. So if I click on that, you see it's, I'll zoom in a little bit actually, you can see the stroke stops about here and it's flat. If we go to the last one, which is square cap, it's still flat, but it just goes a little bit further above. So they're the caps that you can see on an open curve. Now let's go back to this closed curve shape. So I'm just going to click on the move tool and select my star again. So the next one is join. So let's have a look at that. The first one that is already selected is called round, and you can see the star is not very pointy. The next one is bevel join. I will select that, and you can see that it's flattened off the edge there. That's what it says, and that's what it's done. The next one is pointy, so miter join this is called. So if I click on that, it should technically be pointy, and it will happen in most scenarios. Sometimes if you have a shape that's a little bit thin and pointy like this, you have to up the miter, because remember, this is a miter join. So right now it's a 1.5. What if I just put it to 7? There we go. Now we have a pointy edge, or a pointy corner, I should say. So what are the next options? It says align. So right now you can see the actual shape of our star, that's the blue line there, and it's in the center, like it shows in the image there. If we go align stroke to the inside, click on that. Now you can see inside of that blue line, that is where the stroke is now housed. And obviously this one is align stroke to the outside. So I click on that and there we go. So you've got many different options here. I'll just select the first one that we had. Now order. So this one says draw stroke behind. So if I click on that, nothing has happened, okay? And that's because we didn't have a fill. So I'm just going to go back to our color tab here. If I select the fill and I give it that blue and I go back, see the order, draw stroke behind, okay? And now if I draw a stroke in front, it will show the full stroke. So you see this section here, that's like half and that's half. If I click on this, you'll see that that stroke is technically behind. And then you can start playing around with whether it's aligned on the inside or the outside. So many different options. Let's move on from that. So I'm going to get rid of that fill because I no longer want that. Now it says start and end. And again, this is better for an open curve like this one, for instance. So start, I will just click on it. And look, it's given me loads of options of arrowheads and circles, etc. So I can choose triangle for one. That's the start of it. And then for the end, maybe I could have this square here. So basically that's what that does. So you see right now that's the node. If you want it to be right at the end, then you would press that one there. And you got some more options here. Swap arrowhead with tail, the usual stuff that just makes your life a little bit easier. And that's just basically to clear this option here. I pressed it a bit fast there. That one clears the arrowhead, so it's back to how it was before. Now getting a little bit more technical, I won't play around with this too much, but basically there's pressure. I will show you more of this later when we hit the pen and node tool. But basically, this is a pressure profile. Let me just get rid of that one in the middle there. It's a pressure profile, so if I just select one end and I drag it down, it makes one thin and the other thick, and you could do the same for the other side as well. Or you can add a little node in the middle and drag it in like that. But for now, let's just move on from that. Now I want to draw your attention to this checkbox here. It's very important, scale with object. So let's go ahead and scale it without that selected. So I'm going to scale down like this. And what are you noticing? Well, the stroke remains the same size, but it's not scaling with the actual star here. So if we go ahead and check it, scale with object, and now we'll try and rescale again, you can see as the star scales down, so does the stroke. You'll also notice that we have this other option up here, dash line style. So if I click on that, it's going to allow us to have a dashed line style. In fact, I will apply that to our star. So again, I've clicked it. I'll click dash line style, and we've got a dash here. You can play around with the spacing by playing around with these numbers down here. So if I put 5 there and maybe 6 there, basically the first one will be kind of the width of your first dash and then the gap between it. So you can make them equal. And you can keep playing around with these numbers to however you like it. And in fact, I can make the width a little bit smaller so it's more obvious what it's doing. And maybe close these down a little bit. There we go. So there we go. There's a dashed line style. And there is one last thing I'll show you on this. Here it says balanced dash pattern. And basically that refers to each kind of point. So if you look at the ends of the star, there's always a dash there. And that looks very uniform, doesn't it? If I click off of that, it might not be so uniform. And the final option, which I will kind of skim, is basically texture line style, because now we're getting more into the vector brush. So if I click on that, well, it still looks like a black stroke, doesn't it? But if we head on over to brushes down here, and then we choose one of the brushes, let's go for chalk and pastels. I can click on that and apply that to our star, but we'll cover more of that when we get to the vector brush tool. But basically, they are the stroke options. Moving on.